Hello guys, Zendik, and welcome back to a new video in which I'm going to unbox this Redmi's new Redmi Smart Band, which is available for the price tag of 1600 rupees. Mi Band 4 is available for about 2300 rupees and Realme's band is available for 1200 rupees. This is basically in between Mi Band 4 and Realme band. Is this good enough to go for? What are the features? Let's talk about the unboxing experience. Basically, in the box, you get this band and a manual on how to connect it to a smartphone, and that's pretty much it. There is no charger, nothing, because the band comes with a charging mechanism similar to what Realme band had. Simply remove this and attach this to the charger directly and it will start charging. I feel like this is a great solution, considering you do not need to worry about carrying a separate charger for your band. And with Mi Band 4, the biggest issue I faced was not able to find the charger, because 20 days battery life and it usually lasts for 15 to 20 days. I almost every single time forgot where I kept the Mi Band 4's charger, so I stopped using Mi Band 4 itself. Now with the Redmi band, at least that issue won't be there. Now let's talk about the build quality of the band. It is completely made out of plastic and this strap is made out of rubber, which feels pretty good, similar to Mi Band 4. And build quality wise, it feels very sturdy. If I drop it, if I do something like this, it did. I tried it earlier as well and it did not break. I mean, obviously I was not expecting it to break, but it feels little bit bulkier as compared to Mi Band 4. Now let's talk about the display itself. This is a smaller display, but it's a colorful display. As you can see on the screen right now, this is how the display looks. One of the biggest complaints that I have with the Redmi band, Redmi Smart Band, is that I cannot change this sleep time, or I cannot change, or I cannot set it to always on. It always goes back to sleep within, I guess it's 10 seconds. And it's annoying, because when I'm shooting, I want to look at it. Come on, stay up. I tried searching it in the settings, in the band setting, in the app setting, nothing was working. Now let's talk about the interface. You can swipe up and you will get the status, like how many steps you have walked, distance, calories burnt, and idle alerts. So two idle alerts were given to me. Like, I was shooting two videos before shooting this video and the band said, oh, you are sitting on one place for too long, stand up and run. I was like, okay, I'm working right now. But anyway, you get the point. That's there. If you accidentally press, then you can use this button to go back. And the device, it's touchscreen. And heart rate monitor is also there. I'll just press on the heart rate monitor and we'll measure heart rate. So a heart rate of 90 BPM. If we swipe down, then you get option of workout, where there are multiple options such as outdoor running, treadmill, cycling, walking, and freestyle as well. If we scroll down, weather option is available. In Mumbai, the current temperature is 31 degrees Celsius. Air quality is good. Air index is 55, which is pretty good in my area at least. You also get tomorrow's weather, then day after tomorrow's weather, and day after that, and day after that. And I guess that's it. If we scroll down, then you can see notifications. So these are the notifications which are available from WhatsApp. If I click on that, okay, come on, respond. One issue with the touchscreen. Now, as you can see, 7 messages from Pi Chats. I just asked Aryan to send a message, but it's not opening up over here. If I long press. Clear all. Okay, I'll just clear all and now send me a message. Now let's see what happens. I just received, okay, 8 messages from 5 chats, but it's not showing what's the message content. Okay, let me just try. No, it's not going to work, I guess. Now let's try a normal message and let's see if we can click on that. Aryan Kadam said PUBG, because PUBG is banned right now. I told him not to play PUBG. Let's play COD. Send a message on WhatsApp now. Once again, it says 9 messages from 5 chats. And obviously, I do not want to open other people's chat, because then I'll have to reply to them. The regular issue. Unfortunately, it's not opening for some reason right now. And as you can see, the touchscreen is there, but it's not as responsive as Mi Band 4. If I try to, okay, if I try to touch fast and if I try to scroll between them fast, then it's not working. This type of issue is not actually present on the Mi Band 4, and Mi Band 4 is definitely much more responsive as compared to Redmi Smart Band when it comes to touch. As you can see, sometimes I have to press multiple times. In the more option, you get DND, alarm, themes, music, stopwatch, timer, find phone, and settings. If I press on find phone, on my Realme X50 Pro, it will start playing the Xiaomi ringtone. Okay, I'll just stop it now. Sound is off. Okay, yeah, sound is off. Finally. Now, let's look at this. Now, to connect Redmi Smart Band to your smartphone, you need to use this Xiaomi Wear application. You cannot use the Mi Fit application somehow. Mi Band 4 uses the Mi Fit application. Now, connecting the band to your smartphone is pretty easy. I don't really need to show that. Band displays, as you can see, I have selected these three. I have kept this particular one because I wanted to show how good the display on this Redmi Smart Band is, and it's actually pretty good. I would say it's not as fancy looking as Mi Band 4, or it's not that vivid, but it gets the job done, I would say. If you come here in the online section, then you can see that there are multiple watch faces to select from. Mi Band 4 has an unlimited, literally unlimited. You can create your own watch face on Mi Band 4, but that's not possible on the Redmi Smart Band as far as I know. And if you want to change it to, let's say, this one, simply click on sync. That's very easy. I guess it will download it on the phone, then send it to this band via Bluetooth, and then the band will apply it. So it's synced, and as you can see, the band display that we had selected is available over here. And in the app, you do not get much of settings. Alarms can be added from here, notifications. I mean, this is to select which apps can send notifications. If you do not want Amazon applications notification to be seen on the band, then you can simply disable that. Now let's go back, and user guide is there if you are having some issue. Background activity permissions, enable all these permissions so that you will be able to get notifications and you will be able to set alarms and everything. Additional settings, heart rate settings can be set to 24 hours. Basically, it can monitor your heart rate continuously for 24 hours, and that's a pretty good thing. Automatic heart rate detection and heart rate alert can be set. Like, I want notification as soon as my heart rate goes above 100 BPM, because let's assume you have some issue because of which you want to be notified, then that's a good thing. That option is present. Idle alert can be enabled or disabled for people who are working from home right now. If you're planning to buy this, select this and move every once in a while, like every 1 hour, try moving so that your body gets is used to it. Raise to wake screen. Come on, will it work? It's not active right now. Okay, raise to wake is off right now, sorry. I'll just select it. Raise to wake is turned on. And it turned on right now. Once again, now the display is shut down. I'll do this and the display will be turned on. When it comes to accuracy of raise to wake, I felt Mi Band 4 was slightly faster to respond to the wake call. Redmi Band is not that fast. Obviously, the difference of 600 rupees can be seen with the Mi Band 4. And I guess that's pretty much it for Redmi Smart Band's initial impression. One thing that I did not show you, that when it comes to calls, you can only reject the call or you can silence the call on the band itself. It will still keep vibrating or ringing on your device. So that's one thing. You cannot accept calls. You cannot reply to any notifications. And as we saw, we were not able to open WhatsApp notification when there were multiple notifications at the same time. And I guess that's pretty much it for this particular video. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to give this video a huge thumbs up. If you still have any more doubts, suggestions or queries regarding the Redmi Band, then do let me know about that in the comment section box below, or you can tweet it to me at @dhananjay_tech. And subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and press the bell icon so that you get notified next time I upload a video like this one. So yeah, thank you guys, thank you for watching.